Please welcome DMA's Johnny Took. Welcome. You've just been in the UK, I think 50,000 people in Manchester, as well as jet lag. It must be pretty hard hitting the ground here after
all. It wasn't 50,000 for us. We were supporting a band. But
for you. It still counts.
Yeah. But it's great. It's been great for us over there. We just released a new album in March, so I've already been there twice. We've been there twice already this year. And then we're going back again on Tuesday.
Yeah. What you're telling us is you've gotten very good at flying.
I've gotten really good at flying.
Well, it's not just flying that you're doing, because you're touring around Australia in September, and obviously you've toured a whole lot with the band prior. Who has the most annoying habit on tour? Name names.
Drop names?
Yeah.
Do you know what? We're all pretty good. I would probably have to... If I had to think of one thing, like, I've got this kind of... I don't know if I want to say this on TV. Basically, like, our tour manager has us all lined up, you know, like, you're on stage, you know, in, like, you know, 2 minutes or whatever, and we're there and we've got all our in-ears on and we're ready to go. And then, like, OK, he's like, OK, we ready? And then I just kind of run. And I have to go to the toilet. Every time. It's like, even after the last one, there's always one more.
Did you do that just before you came on here?
And he's like... It's
bolted. Have you ever missed a set?
No, I think the other guys kind of like it. Like, they're like, oh, I've got a couple more minutes to chill.
Well, tomorrow a radio station called Triple J doing something called the Hottest 100 of Like Versions. I don't know, sounds lame. But
says the man who just quit Triple J.
If I'm also watching, I'm joking. But we saw in that incredible package your incredible cover of Cher's Belief. It's, you know... a lot of people are saying that could be up the pointy end of the countdown. I mean, how are you feeling about it? It's such a wonderful, wonderful song.
Oh, man, it's such a great segment, that Like a Version segment. So for people to be saying that, you know, we'll be kind of up that side of it, will be pretty cool at the top end. And the crazy thing is with that performance is, like, I was playing the wrong chords, I think, the morning before, like, that morning. Like, we were running through it and I was playing the wrong chords and...
It's in the old small studio as
That's right, that's right. I remember, like, I lived above a pub, and so we were trying to... Me and Mason lived above this pub, but the parking had gates and the remote wasn't working for the gate. So we were meant to drive from Botany to get to the studios and we couldn't get out, so we're throwing our guitars over the top. It was a disaster. And then, like, you know, we're all, like I said, playing the wrong chords, and then, like, oh, shit. And then I'm like, get in there, and it just happened so quickly, and then all of a sudden it's on the internet, and then, you know, it's people Huge. Are loving it.
It's
just so weird how... such a fleeting moment like that can...
But now you perform it, like, globally, right?
Yeah, that's right.
In front of those tens of thousands of fans.
It's, you know, I think if you can... It's fun chucking it in the set because, you know, the more sing-alongs you have at the set, especially at festivals and stuff, and, like, the first time we played it live properly was at Splendor 1 year, and it was a really special moment, so it's cool to be able to do that.
Has Cher ever, like... come at you wanting, thanking you for the royalties that you've given her?
I wish. No, I'd love to know if she's seen it or not, but either way, it's all a bit of fun at school.
Hey, your wife, Hayley Mary, has also done a Like a Version cover. It's also beautiful. Does that create tension in the house for who's going to come out on top, or are you...?
I much prefer her cover.
Oh, OK.
She does a Lana Del Rey cover. If you guys haven't seen it, it's amazing.
It's
she's got a great band. And,
yeah. Did she tell you to say this, or...?
No. But I'm a good husband.
Yeah. Well, also, speaking of the UK tour you've been doing, Liam Gallagher of Oasis fame has kind of given you guys blessings. He's a huge fan of what you guys do. You know, that must be really exciting. Do you think you were maybe the only people who he said positive things about ever in his life?
I think most of... I don't know. Whenever I talk to Liam, he's like... Like, he can... He's got, like, attitude and stuff, but it's normally, like, he supports young music so much. Like, he really loves it. And I don't think... And it's never anything, like, nasty or anything, you know? It's kind of just a bit of that English banter kind of thing.
Oh, yeah.
It's just a big fan of The Nervous Week.
Yeah.
Obviously. You can find out all the info about DMA's upcoming tour over on our website now. Would you please put your hands together for Johnny Took?